previous tutorial we have seen how to integrate JPA and Hibernate using Spring Boot. So in that tutorial we have seen how to create a student entity and how to create a student repository and how we can insert the data with the help of script called data.sql. So now if you run this, so this script will execute and it will generate the database and it will insert the content, the student ID as 123 and first name and the last name and so on. So if you check that, yes, it's there. So now in this tutorial we are going to see about inserting this type of content without using these the script. We are going to insert the content for the student database. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this, and we have two things like model and repository, and I'm going to add one more thing called service, and I'm going to create a class called student service. So this student service will insert the content. So yeah, so this student service is a service which will enable us to insert the content in the database. So we call this annotation as service, and so this service will get the content from the student repository. So we have to create the object for the student repository, private student repository, then we have to create an object called student repository, and then we have to create a something called constructor here. So the constructor is generated, and we have to make this as auto-wired because it will execute automatically. So auto-wired, and to load the content into the table we have to create a method. So I'm going to use a method called load data. You can use any name. For our understanding I put load data, and this load data, this method will call automatically. So I'm going to put annotation called post construct. So if you put this post construct, it will call this automatically. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create the object for the student, and using that object I'm going to assign the value, and similarly I'm going to call the student repository to save the content. So first it's student followed by some object equal to new student, so I'm creating in the object for that. And so since this long is auto generated, I'm not going to store any value because it is generated by itself. So the strategy is generation type dot auto, so I'm just going to store the first name and the last name. So student dot set first name, student dot set first name, I'm going to put some value. Then student dot set last name, I'm going to put some value. So now the value has been set. Now I'm going to store this in the student repository. So student repository dot save student. So in the demo application I will create an object for the student repository. I'm going to make this as private, or I just can just create that object. Then I will make this as also the auto wired. That's all. So now if you run this, yeah, So we'll just check this. So disconnection, then connect, then the student is created, and we'll just check this. Yeah, the ID is created as 1 because we have not set any value, since it is a auto-generated value, because we put the strategy as the generation type as auto, then we set the first name and the last name. So this is how we will assign the value, or we can using the service we can assign the value for that particular class, and we can save it with the help of student repository, because we know that this student repository is extending the JPA repository, and this JPA repository extends some other class, and that particular class will have something called save in it. So using that method, it saves the content. So this is how we will store the content without the help of the script called data.sql. Thank you. If you like this video, please subscribe to this channel.